When I was but a young man, I was wild and full of fire. A youth within my teens, but full of challenge and desire. I ran away from home and left my mother and my dad. I know it grieved them so to think their only boy was bad. I fell in with an outlaw band, their names were known quite well. How many times we robbed...
What habit have you created that has improved your life?
Well, probably quitting drinking. Probably improved my life because I used to drink too much. It wasn't that I was just a drunkard, but I would come in of evening and drink too much, and I got to wanting to come in early just for that reason. Anyway, I'd say that was a habit that I kicked that helped my life more than anything.
Make you feel better?
Oh yeah, feel better and do better work, get along with people better and happier.
Yeah.
But you know, the Bible says not to overdo the drinking, and I was overdoing it, so I feel like I've got it conquered.
You found that point where you said, hey, enough's enough.
That's right.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Plundered, I could never tell. This kind of sinful living leads only to a fall. I learned that much and more the night I heard my master call. One night we rustled cattle, 1,000 head or so, and
so when are you the happiest? On a daily basis?
Well, when I'm horseback.
That's what I was thinking.
I'd be, it, when I'm horseback and on a pretty morning, and I've been horseback when I wasn't so happy because it'd been so cold I couldn't hardly stand it, or so hot you couldn't hardly stand it, but been out there a lot of time when the weather was perfect, just like it's been here for two days.
Man, it's been nice too, hasn't it?
It's been nice.
Now, speaking of being horseback, you know, rumor has been going around that because I've been such a good hand for the past 2 days, you were thinking about giving me that blue roan horse. Is that false?
I think it must be false because I hadn't heard of it and I hadn't thought of it.
Are you sure it was a nice one?
I'm pretty sure it's not going
to happen. It's them out on the trail that leads to Mexico. But a norther started blowing and lightning flashed about. I thought someone was calling me. I thought I heard a shout.
Okay, if you could spend the day with anyone, dead or alive, okay, if you could spend the day with that person, ride that blue roan horse with somebody, who would it be?
Probably my dad.
Your dad?
Yeah. Yeah, he was quite a guy. He was working during the drought and depression. He was working for $1 a day at the McFadden Ranch. And he and the manager of the McFadden got a little money together and leased the ranch in Stonewall County. But they couldn't stock it because they didn't have the money, so they ran somebody else's cattle. And they got it going that way, and then eventually they got it stocked, and then eventually they bought a little land, and then Daddy just kept adding on to that and to have the ranch that we have now. And he had no inheritance, no oil, no nothing. He just hard work. And he and Mother just, needless to say, they didn't spend much money. They lived pretty close because they couldn't.
Right.
And there are four of us boys, and I'm sure that we were part of the reason they were keeping the ranch together and not spending any money. They were tight.
Right.
But nowadays people call me tight. I almost want to thank them because if I wasn't tight, I wouldn't be in the cattle business.
It'd be tough, wouldn't it?
It'd be tough.
Yeah, because you got to kind of pinch your pennies, don't you?
Oh, yeah, dang right.
So, you and your brothers, you have any sisters?
No.
All boys?
Just all boys. Four boys.
Y'all, your dad work you every day?
Every day.
Yeah, made hands out of you.
Yeah, and he didn't overdo it. I mean, you know, he let us play, but we did work. After school, before school, and I remember one time we used to haul hay before school or feed cattle before school, and then we had an old pickup, didn't have any doors in it. We drove it to school back.
It didn't have any doors?
No, it had a cow horn on the front. We had red tail lights stuck in the eyes of the old cow horn. But anyway, and then we had a lot of geese, so we'd use a 30-30 and run the geese off the fields. And we killed one day, and so we thought, well, we'll take town. We got town, and we was late. Class had already taken up, so we snuck that goose in there, and there's a lady there, a girl there named Nanny Lou Gilbert, and she was sort of squeamish anyway. So we went to her locker and hung that old goose up on the court, on the hat rack like that, and then waited till class was over. And we heard her scream, and we thought if they catch us, they'll put us in jail. But they didn't catch us.
Heard us shout. Then at that moment, lightning struck not 20 yards from me. And left there was a giant cross where once there was a tree. And this time I knew I heard
it. Even if you choose to do something later in life, do you feel like God called you to this way of life for a purpose?
Yeah, I think so.
When I say purpose.
Sure, I know so. Because God has purpose for all of us. I know it's God's plan and not mine. I try to ask that it's His will that I'm doing every day, especially here lately, because I don't know what to do. So it's got to be His, because I ask Him every day.
And it's just one step at a time. Yeah. And you know, even do you feel like even if you somewhere in your lifetime you choose to do something different, which probably not, but if you do, do you feel like this will be a stepping stone to the next place in your life?
Oh, sure.
All preparation?
Yeah, just rural life and agriculture life, just learn how to weld and cowboy and learn how to get around in pastures like we were talking about earlier and sense of direction and just tons and tons of life skills, and I feel like they go to a lot of other things and get you a head start on doing other things and on the business side of it. Business is business.
Do you think the ranch life builds character for a man?
Yeah, definitely. It builds character, breaks you down.
Yeah.
Strange, a voice that came from everywhere, a voice that called my name. So frightened I was thinking of sinful deeds I'd done. I failed to see the thousand head of cattle start to run. The cattle they stampeded were running all around.
So last question. Do you guys feel just fulfilled in your lifestyle?
Yes, sir. I do. I think it's important, though, that cowboys' life, you know, we chose cowboy life, and that's what everything you strive for, and you should, you know, do everything you do as unto God. But I think it's pretty easy to make cowboy or cowboying or work an idol, and you got to separate that.
Always keeping God first. Blessings beneath. Yeah, I agree with you 100%. Yeah, because it can easy, can't it? And that's all you think about, and that's all you want to do, and sometimes you forget. But if you don't,
you remember, you know, not trying to be the coolest cowboy or you're picturing yourself as the best bronc rider or something, and you're asking, you know, what do I need to do, and where do I need to go, and what I need to do today, or whatever. That, I mean, if you're asking that, it's not like as a cowboy, what are you going to, you know, do I need to go work in an oil field today, or do I need to go to New York to do something? I hope that's not it. But, you know, I mean, if you're asking that question, you got to be sincere. And so once you do that and you humble yourself, you can kind of drop the having to be a cowboy and cowboy and being number one, you allow yourself to be a better cowboy, kind of get around that way.
Well, in other words, your focus changes. You're willing to whatever God asks you to do, you will do.
Yes. I hope so. I don't know what he tells me what it is, I might change my mind.
Unless he tells you to go to New York?
Yeah, but it should be. If I'm asking and being honest, you know, a lot of times I don't, you know, oh, this is an easy one. You know, you're doctoring your early and everything's dying, and you're like, man, I I don't know about just being a cowboy today. Maybe I should do
Make
something else.
Make yourself guess,
huh? Yeah.
But do you learn that you take the good with the bad?
Sure, yes, sir.
And even though the bad things happen, do you allow the good to override that when you stay focused on that positive mode of on the good thing? Because, you know, in anything you do, whether it's cowboy or whatever, if you're always focused on the negative things, the bad things that'll happen, then you miss all the good things. Do you agree with that?
Right. Well, was it Job that was tested, you know, and it you build upon it and it makes you stronger and you know, like Jake's Bible, God has plans to prosper you and not to harm you, and so you know that there's something good to come out of it and you can learn from it. And always study about joy, and joy doesn't mean necessarily happiness. In the trials, you have joy through the trials and through the hardship.
That's a good answer. Because, see, joy, happiness can be robbed from it.
Right.
It's the opposite of happiness is sad. But joy, if you've got joy, no one can take that from you. And you can have joy even in your worst moments. So yes, that's a good
My time. Pony ran but stumbled, and it threw me to the ground. I felt the end was near, that death would be the price, when a mighty bolt of lightning showed the face of Jesus Christ. And I cried, oh Lord, forgive me, don't let it happen now. I want to live for you alone, oh God, these words I vow. My wicked past unfolded, I thought of wasted years, when another bolt of lightning killed 100 head of steers, and the others rushed on by me, and I was left to live. The Master.